Bogey Brothas.
Par 3, 130 yards over what looks to be like a huge bunker. It's almost like an island green, y'all.
A little bit short.
Dang, I'm in the dirt. Wow.
Now, you out in the desert somewhere, huh?
Yep.
Oh, you're just short, barely. You're pin high almost.
I have a whole lot of green to work with over here. Smart move would be to go over here.
Is that what you're doing?
What I'm gonna do.
Really? Okay. Too peasy with the smart move for once.
Wait, this is not a bunker, right?
Bogey Brothas.
So I can ground my club here for a practice swing?
Huh. I don't know about that.
Maybe we should ask Fred.
Maybe we should ask Fredro Parr.
This is not a bunker for sure.
Fredro, I don't know if this is considered a bunker. I don't know what this is considered, but maybe you could give us some insight on whether or not Too Peasy can do a practice swing and ground his club.
Well, guys, this is actually a pretty good question. I think we need to start by understanding that under the rules of golf, there are 5 defined areas of the golf course. And the first area would be the teeing ground. Then there is the putting green. There are penalty areas, like a water hazard. Then there are bunkers. And lastly, there is what's called the general area. Now, the general area is defined as everything else, essentially. It's the fairway, the rough, the trees, everything not listed in those previous 4. Now, a waste area falls into the category of the general area because it's not part of the other 4 areas. As such, you treat it as if you were in the fairway, or the rough, or the trees. The key is understanding whether or not you're actually in a waste area. It's very important to understand this because Dustin Johnson probably lost a PGA championship as a result of not remembering this rule. Now in 2010, Dustin Johnson at the PGA championship at Whistling Straits had a 1-shot lead going to the 72nd hole. He hit his drive out to the right into the gallery. And when the gallery cleared where his ball was, Dustin appeared to be in a dirty, sandy area. He set his club down behind the ball, hit the shot, and finished the hole. Now, he had a 1-shot lead, but he had made what he thought was a bogey and would have been tied and in a playoff for the PGA Championship. It was at that point in which a rules official walked up to him and told him that he had, in fact, grounded his club in a bunker. The result of this was that he incurred the general penalty of 2 strokes. Taking him out of a tie for the lead and the playoff for the PGA Championship. Now, if Dustin was in fact playing the match play event, as you gentlemen do sometimes, he would not have incurred a 2-shot penalty, but in fact, he would have incurred a loss of hole. So keep that in mind, what you can and can't do in a bunker, and make sure that you do know and understand whether or not you're playing out of a waste area.
All right, he's out of the bunker.
It's not a bunker, bro.
Bogey Brothas.